to Wednesday. I've just got back from the gym. It was extremely sweaty, as you can probably tell, but it was just my accessory day today, so I just did some good mornings and some belt squats. A lot of volume, hence why I'm feeling like I am Niagara Falls at the moment. Push up, but what you would have just seen was Monday's training session, where I managed to bench. I didn't manage to bench a lot, but I did manage to bench. So over the last couple of weeks, I have been getting a bit of a reoccurrence of my pec issues, and I've basically decided that enough is enough, and I really need to focus on my prehab, my rehab, and just really get to the bottom of what is causing the issue. And I've had an issue with my sort of scapula, my rhomboids, for quite a long time, where it always feels super tight on this side. So I've decided that I really need to focus in on that, and that's what I did on Monday. So I showed you a few of the warm-ups that I have basically done, so I'm making sure that I'm really activating my scapula, but I'm also just switching off my rhomboids, and I'm doing that by using a spiky ball, but I've also got a lacrosse ball that I'm going to be using, and a foam roller, and that's really what I'm adding in. I'm just adding in something that's really going to sort of loosen up my back, because I'm realizing that I'm not actually getting a very good range of motion, which I think is putting the extra strain on my pec, because obviously my pec's getting a lot tighter because I haven't been able to get through that greater range. So that's something that I'm going to be doing pretty much every day. I'm going to try and do it every morning, is just do a little bit of prehab so it feels nice and loose for my bench sessions. But yeah, you're probably wondering why I'm stood here with a big old steak, and that's because I've not actually eaten anything today, so I'm feeling a little bit delirious. So I've got a big 500 gram ribeye here, which I'm going to reverse here. So I'm going to whack it in the oven now for 15 minutes and then grill it up. Let's give this a little taste test. I'm going to go straight for the middle. Whoa. This is a big boy. Oh my god. So tender, so juicy. Can taste the kind of like brown butter with the thyme and rosemary with it. Unreal. This is probably the best steak I have ever made. So I'm just eating this with a load of stuff that I have in my fridge. Pasta, Spanish tortilla, homemade guacamole, and obviously half a kilo of steak. Right, I'm gonna devour this, and then I'm gonna talk to you a little bit more about my bench prehab and my bench plan going forward on Friday. Thank you. Okay, back from the gym. Final gym session of the week complete. Very happy to get up to 125 kilo on the bench again with no issues. So what I've been doing over the last week, maybe, is starting to work. And I quickly wanted to go over my bench plan and my prehab, rehab stuff in a little bit more detail and my thought process behind it, because obviously I'm studying to be a physiotherapist and I'm taught within that to be very evidence-based. So everything has to be based off of evidence and research to inform your practice. So if I'm going to go and treat a patient, I can't just wing it and anecdotally treat people based off of just what I think something is and what I think is going to help. It has to be based off of evidence. So I've got quite good, I suppose, at critically appraising pieces of research, articles and that sort of thing. And generally the evidence towards manual therapy isn't that good. However, I feel like I am quite open-minded about having things put into context and anecdotal evidence, probably not when it comes to my patients, but definitely on myself, because basically I am a guinea pig to myself, so I can try different things and I can see what works. And that won't always show in research papers because they're normally very controlled with certain parameters that need to be fit in order to it to be fair and unbiased. And often that isn't a power lifter, which is very specific to bench press and things like that. So anecdotally, I can try things on myself and see if they work, because up until this point, the things that I've been trying clearly haven't worked because I've had so many reoccurring injuries in my pec that clearly just the wait and see method, which is kind of what I've been doing, which is just letting it heal and just get back to it really, hasn't worked. And it comes back to that sort of Einstein saying, which is something along the lines of, if you repeat something over and over again expecting different results, that's a sign of insanity. And yeah, that's kind of the way I was starting to feel, is the fact that I was just flogging a dead horse, expecting different results by basically doing the same thing and waiting and seeing. So I've had to try something different, which is basically going against the grain as to what the evidence says, which is that manual therapy isn't really I think the word's reliable as a treatment option, but obviously that's what I've been trying. So I've been getting the lacrosse ball in and around my scapula because I feel like that is where the issue is coming from. However, there is, again, research to say that scapular dyskinesia and scapular winging and that sort of thing isn't anything to worry about in terms of how it can replicate pain and dysfunction in the shoulder. There isn't evidence or strong enough evidence to suggest that that's actually an issue or can cause issues. But again, anecdotally, I know that when I sort of loosen up my shoulder blade and the muscles in and around there just by using manual therapy, I do temporarily get better range through my shoulder, which makes me feel like I can bench safer. And again, how this actually works, I don't know. And it could just be a psychological thing as well, because I think that I'm doing something different, therefore my body is reacting in a different way. I'm also loading my bench a little bit more over to my right side now, I'm finding, so I'm actually not giving this pec as much of a stretch, so that could be the contributing factor. So there's lots of different things that could be contributing as to why I'm feeling quite good on my bench at the moment and I'm not feeling like the pec is in any danger. But again, it's all down to my anecdotal experience, and a lot of what I'm doing really isn't based off of research, because the research really does suggest that posture and asymmetry isn't an issue when it comes to lifting. But again, I feel like there needs to be more context, especially when it comes to very niche sports like powerlifting, which isn't very highly well researched. So that's really my mindset towards this, and it is not necessarily going exactly according to what research is saying, but just trial and error. So I'm trying different things because clearly what I've been trying before hasn't massively been working, and we'll just kind of wait and see again. So I'm gonna continue with this because I have felt a benefit of just that sort of manual therapy, that massage therapy in and around my shoulder. I have felt more loose and I haven't felt that sort of internal rotation, which is kind of something that I've really been noticing, is that I have been feeling really tight in and around my shoulder and my pec. So now that I'm loosening that up and stretching it, that seems to be helping. So that's what I'm going to stick with for now. So anecdotally, I'll only know if it's really worked when I give it enough time to really see the results. But yeah, that's kind of my mindset towards all of it. I am definitely still more research-based with more conventional things when it comes to sort of rehab and physiotherapy in general, because I have to be in a way, because that informs my practice, like I say, and I can't do things which I just think are right. I need to have it evidenced and it needs to be following particular guidelines. But when it comes to myself, you know, I can pretty much do what I want.
Oh, welcome to Saturday. This is the third county that we have been in today. Obviously Bristol, and we've just been to Essex. Sorry, I say we, me and Lois. We have been to Essex for my mate's charity football tournament, which was a lot of fun, but very hot. And now we're just in Kent at my friend Dan's house. I think I have actually recorded videos here before, and Dan has been in the YouTube a few times. But yeah, we're just spending the evening here, chilling out. But yeah, ironically, I've actually managed to hurt my back. And how have I managed to do that?
He was yawning this morning.
So I can do all of this rehab on my back and play around with my back being all fancy with the foam rolling and everything, and all it takes is a little yawn to tweak my back. So
I mean, it was a pretty big yawn, wasn't it?
It was a big yawn. But yeah, sod's law, I've hurt my back, which is really annoying. But yeah, I'm going to pretty much wrap up the video now, guys. Yeah, haven't really got much more to say, just going to enjoy my evening. Dan is making a lovely dinner for us while we spend the evening here, so looking forward to that. But yeah, I hope you guys have enjoyed the video. Please leave it a like if you have, subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.
Peace.
Yeah.